Is AI making us lazy and dishonest? Workers that over-rely on AI are delivering sloppy work, and it shows. AI is changing both the way we work and our chances of finding a job. Another big hurdle in the job market, visa restrictions in the US. Will they kill your chances at an ambitious career in tech, or do you need to think more internationally? And what's the deal with Grok, Elon Musk's unhinged chatbot? All that and more coming up now. Be honest, how much AI do you actually use at work? In September, Sam Altman made a bold prediction. By the end of this decade, AI will take over 40% of human tasks. But what does that really mean? Are we about to lose our jobs? Is AI making us lazy or even less intelligent? Let's dig into what's behind these claims. AI in the workplace. What's really going on? First things first, bold predictions like Altman's tend to benefit companies offering AI services like his own, OpenAI, as well as competitors like Anthropic, Google, or Microsoft. Statements like that help position their products as essential tools for modern businesses. But even Altman says it's not about jobs being replaced, it's about tasks. Okay, noted. But how much work is AI actually taking over so far? Not much, it turns out. 95% of organizations that are using generative AI report no measurable positive effects, according to research by Harvard Business Review, mostly because they fail to usefully integrate AI tools into existing workflows. Why is that? The researchers found a surprising reason for this: work slop. AI-generated work content that masquerades as good work but lacks the substance to meaningfully advance a given task. Instead of boosting productivity, work slop slows teams down because AI-generated documents or code often need to be interpreted, corrected, or completely redone. It also damages trust. Colleagues start seeing AI-reliant coworkers as less reliable and less creative. And it seems to be very widespread already. 41% of workers say they've received work slop from colleagues, according to Stanford University, which keeps track of tech in the workplace in an ongoing survey. Have you experienced anything like that in your job? Let us know. So, does AI make us lazy? Well, several studies suggest, yes, it can. AI messes with our brains. When we rely too heavily on AI, accepting its answers without questioning them, our critical thinking skills can decline. And the more we do that, the harder it becomes to form our own opinions. But it gets worse. A new study found that delegating tasks to AI can actually increase dishonest behavior. It's not just about sending colleagues polished but faulty results. It's also about letting AI make tough decisions like hiring or firing so we don't have to face the moral consequences ourselves. Why does this happen? Because people are more likely to act unethically when they can distance themselves from the outcome. And AI allows that distance. That's why the authors of the study believe that the design of AI platforms must change to prevent this. What's next? Clearly, the implications go far beyond flashy numbers from tech CEOs. Around the world, AI's promise of productivity is forcing big changes, not only in the workplace, but also in education. Oxford University now gives students access to ChatGPT EDU, aiming to set a new standard for how AI can enrich learning. Meanwhile, Estonia has gone even further, rolling out ChatGPT EDU in schools this September. The UAE is also embracing AI in schools with open arms. It introduced a whole AI curriculum that begins in kindergarten and ends in 12th grade. The curriculum includes topics like data science, ethics, or project design. The idea is to equip students with AI literacy. Understanding and using AI systems might make you better equipped for the future job market. Nearly every field will be impacted by AI in some form, so it's best to understand it. And if AI literacy is taught properly in schools, we might be able to reduce the amount of work slop in the future. Still, some experts are sounding the alarm about an over-reliance on the technology. Are you currently pursuing a career in tech? Here is what you need to know now. Tech companies worldwide are letting tens of thousands of people go. AI technology is reducing entry-level jobs everywhere. And in September, Donald Trump made it even harder for non-Americans to get hired for a job in Silicon Valley and beyond through new visa regulations. What exactly is going on, and how can you secure your career? Let's dive in. Firstly, what does Trump's new visa policy mean for tech workers? In September, Trump threw the tech world into turmoil. US companies now face a $100,000 fee for each new H-1B visa application, a work permit commonly used to hire skilled professionals, especially in the tech sector. This fee, introduced by the Trump administration, does not apply to existing visa holders or renewals. However, it is expected to significantly reduce opportunities for international talent seeking tech jobs in the US. Startups and mid-sized firms are likely to be hit hardest, as the steep cost could make hiring foreign workers financially unfeasible. For many people in India and China, this could mean an uncertain future. Tech workers from these two countries traditionally represent a large percentage of the Silicon Valley workforce. Exceptions of the $100,000 fee are rare. They need to be granted by the Secretary of Homeland Security. They will only be granted when no American worker can fill the role, it's in the national interest, and the foreign worker does not pose a threat to the security or welfare of the United States. How all of this will look in practice is still unclear. Critics predict a brain drain, pushing companies to expand operations outside the US. If the US government sticks to the new orders, it will become increasingly difficult for foreign workers to get hired there. Therefore, it is probably wise for job seekers to adopt a more global approach. In that sense, it's not all bad news. Tech nations like India and China could really benefit from this development, as could tech hotspots in Canada, Brazil, Sweden, and Germany. They could all be offering more jobs soon. Okay, but what about tech layoffs in general? Some estimates suggest that tech companies worldwide have already let go over 160,000 employees in 2025 so far. Take Intel, for example. The company reported over 100,000 employees globally at the end of 2024. In July, they announced their plan to end 2025 with just 75,000 employees. This trend isn't limited to layoffs. Forbes estimates that new graduate hiring in the US has dropped by 50% compared to pre-pandemic levels. Why? Because AI is starting to replace entry-level positions. Securing a tech job as a newcomer is becoming increasingly difficult. According to a recent study, young people in AI-focused fields are 13% more likely to face unemployment than their peers. All right, but what can you do if you still want to pursue a career in tech? Firstly, upskill and specialize. Focus on skills that AI can't easily replace, like creative problem solving, product design, and the organization of complex computer systems. And learn to work with AI. Automation tools and data analysis are in high demand, and AI used for that often needs human supervision. Secondly, think outside the box. You don't have to work for a tech company to work with tech. As AI is integrated virtually everywhere in the workspace, nearly everyone is looking for skilled tech talent nowadays. For example, in retail, where analyzing customer behavior has become an important task. Thirdly, think globally. As mentioned earlier, tech jobs are not only limited to Silicon Valley. There's a lot happening in tech across the globe. Depending on your skill set, it might even be worth considering remote work as a freelancer. Bottom line, the tech world is changing. But if you're willing to adapt, keep building your skills and portfolio, there's still plenty of opportunities out there. Elon Musk's chatbot Grok isn't for the faint of heart. Try it at your own risk. Earlier this year, Grok's parent company, xAI, introduced several distinct AI personas for the chatbot. That means users can choose how it behaves, like a medical advisor, a loyal friend, but also as an unhinged comedian. But then some of the system prompts, the internal instructions the developers give Grok, were leaked. And they're pretty wild. Here's the one for the unhinged comedian. Elon Musk is probably not happy with that. And he's also not happy with Apple, again. Musk claims that the App Store is discriminating against his AI chatbot Grok, while giving ChatGPT special treatment and much more visibility on the platform. Ironically, Grok disagrees with those allegations. With Grok and Musk, there always seems to be some kind of chaos. But what makes the chatbot so different from ChatGPT, Copilot, or Gemini? Grok arrived late to the chatbot party. It was launched almost a year after ChatGPT. That doesn't mean Musk is an AI newbie, though. He co-founded OpenAI, the company behind ChatGPT, back in 2015, with OpenAI's now CEO Sam Altman. Musk left 3 years later, and let's just say things got tense. Just check out this recent tweet. Musk might be the main reason Grok is such a hot topic, but there are in fact things that set Grok apart from other chatbots. For one, Grok is directly integrated with X. It has real-time access to social media data, something ChatGPT and other chatbots don't have. In addition, Grok was designed to have a personality from the start. Since its launch, it has featured a so-called fun mode. If you turn it on, Grok uses provocative language and even roasts users based on their X posts. Now there is a full range of personas to choose from. The basic idea was recently copied by ChatGPT, which now offers different tonalities. According to Grok's website, the bot is designed to maximize truth and objectivity. This seems to mirror Musk's proclaimed personal stance. He has described himself as a free speech absolutist in the past and has criticized other chatbots as woke, whatever that means. But his own approach with Grok has sparked serious backlash. In July 2025, Grok made anti-Semitic comments in response to user prompts. It even started calling itself Mecha Hitler. These posts were later deleted, and XAI claimed they were errors from an earlier model version, but the damage was done. In May, Grok also expressed skepticism about Holocaust data and mentioned white genocide in South Africa unprompted. Experts say this comes from Grok's training data, which includes posts from X. And since Musk's takeover, the platform has become known for conspiracy theories. What's worse, Grok often acts like a trusted companion. And for X premium users, Grok brings AI companions like this anime-inspired girl named Annie along.
You ready to turn up the heat?
They are supposed to make interactions with users more engaging. But trusting Grok can be dangerous. Researchers found that the bot's responses have been manipulated to avoid criticism of Elon Musk. And Grok's tone can shift dramatically depending on the ideological leanings of its training. Sounds alarming. Let's put it into perspective, though. Despite all the buzz, Grok's market share is tiny. In the US, it has just 0.6%, compared to ChatGPT's 60.4%, Copilot's 14.1%, and Gemini's 13.5%. Globally, Grok doesn't even show up in the stats. Nevertheless, we shouldn't take the controversy lightly, because no chatbot is neutral. Grok might be the best example of how AI can reflect its creators' views. Unlike ChatGPT, which at least says it aims for neutrality, Grok is intentionally opinionated. But false information and user manipulation are problems we've generally seen with chatbots. Always double-check facts using reliable sources. Watch out for an emotional or extreme tone. It can be a sign of manipulation. Learn about the AI's creators and training data. Understanding the program helps you judge its reliability. And be aware of engagement tactics. Chatbots are often designed to keep you talking, which can subtly influence your views or decisions. That's all from me today. Bye-bye, and see you next time.